Hey, Dr. Joe McCullough here. Welcome to my first video blog of 2015. This month, I'd like to talk a little bit about the top 10 rules of bad studying. This comes from a best-selling book called A Mind for Numbers, How to Excel at Math and Science, Even If You Flunked Algebra, written by Dr. Barbara Oakley. On my blog, I listed the top 10 rules and gave a brief description of each one. What I'd like to do now is talk about each one and how it applies to physics specifically, but generally any math, science, engineering class where you're solving problems on a regular basis. So let's take a look at each one and how we can apply that to physics. Rule number one of bad studying is passive rereading. Sitting passively and just rereading pages of a textbook without really concentrating and focusing on what you're reading. Ideally, what you want is at the end of each page to be able to mentally recall what you just read. And I would say this doesn't only apply to rereading, but just reading the first time. Especially for a physics, engineering, science textbook, you want to read with pen in hand. If there's any example problems, after you're done reading it, you then want to go and do the problem yourself with pen and paper, try and solve the problem or derive equations without looking back at the textbook. Active reading, active note-taking is one of the keys to being a successful student. Rule number two is letting highlights overwhelm you. Basically, this rule is just saying don't over-highlight, and especially don't highlight something if you do not understand it. One of the mistakes I've seen students make is they highlight information they don't really understand, thinking they're going to come back, reread it, and then understand it later. Not usually going to happen. Make sure you highlight sparingly, and anything you highlight, make sure you really, really understand what you're highlighting. Bad studying rule number three is merely glancing at a problem's solutions and thinking you know how to do it. This is a mistake I see students make all the time, is looking at a problem's solutions and then thinking they really understand it. I'm here to tell you that if you can't do the problem on your own from start to finish without referring to the solutions, then you don't really understand it and you need to study it more. So if you are working a problem and you have the solutions, if you do glance at them, make sure that at some point you do the entire problem from start to finish without referring to the solutions. Rule number four, waiting until the last minute to study. I know as students you're all busy and sometimes it seems like that's the way it has to happen. But let me tell you, waiting until the last minute to study is one of the worst things you can do as a student. The brain is a muscle and it takes time to train and strengthen. And learning a new subject is really just strengthening that muscle in the brain, and it needs time. It needs repeated exposures with space between each exposure. You can't really cram for an exam and retain that information long term. What you need is repeated exposures spaced out over time. No cramming allowed. Bad. Rule number five of bad studying is repeatedly solving problems of the same type that you already know how to solve. As a math, science, engineering, physics student, you want to be exposed to as many different kinds of problems as you can and solve as many different kinds and types of problems that you can get your hands on. I see students often studying for an exam by just redoing the problems from the homework, redoing the problems, the example problems from class. While it's not bad to redo problems, if you just keep doing the same type of problem, you're not gaining any new knowledge. What you want to do is pick out problems that you haven't done before, try and do those problems without referring to solutions or any kind of notes, and give yourself as much exposure to as many different types of problems as you can. Bad studying rule number six is letting study sessions with friends turn into chat sessions. I think this rule is pretty self-explanatory. Now, I highly recommend studying with friends and classmates. The peer interactions, bouncing ideas off of each other, explaining what you know to somebody else, all of that can be extremely valuable. However, the problem is that oftentimes these study sessions can be a bit too social, and there's more chatting and socializing going on than actually studying and problem solving. So if you're going to study with friends and classmates, make sure to stay focused and do more studying than socializing. Bad studying rule number 7 is neglecting to read the textbook before you start working problems. I would add to this neglecting to read the textbook before you come to class. It's extremely difficult to learn something the very first time you're exposed to it. As I said before, you need multiple exposures. Reading the textbook before you come to class exposes your brain to the information, to the vocabulary, to the terms that you're going to be learning, making it that much easier to absorb the information. Now, also glancing through the textbook before solving problems is a great idea. One of the worst mistakes I see students make is going right to the problems, reading the problem, and then trying to mindlessly find an equation that fits the situation without really understanding what's going on. So read the textbook before class, glance through the textbook before working on problems, and make sure you give your brain the repeated exposures it needs in order to really learn the information. Rule number 8 of bad studying is not checking with the instructor or classmates to clear up points of confusion. Now in physics, this is a real killer, because just like all the sciences, math, engineering classes, the topics build upon each other. What you learn at the end of the semester is going to build upon what you learn at the beginning of the semester. So if you have a point of confusion and you don't clear it up, you're going to find that it keeps coming up again and again and again. So as soon as you find yourself not understanding something, check with a classmate, check with the instructor, check with a tutor, make sure you clear up the confusion before the next class. Bad studying rule number 9 is thinking that you can learn deeply when you are being constantly distracted. Learning requires focus, and there's no such thing as multitasking when learning is involved. Your brain has to focus on what you want to take into your long-term memory and really learn. So put away the email, the Facebook, the cell phones. Every time your focus shifts to something else, your comprehension drops. This is why, as a college instructor, I do not allow cell phones in my class. It's not possible to learn effectively while you're constantly being distracted by texts and emails. So put away the cell phone. Put away the email, stop checking Facebook, and focus on what you're doing. And the last rule of bad studying, but certainly not the least, is not getting enough sleep. I know as a student you're very busy, you have a lot on your plate, and oftentimes it seems like the only way to get everything done is to sacrifice sleep. I'm here to tell you that it's a bad idea. What you learn during the day, all of those memories that you're trying to form, they get consolidated and stored while sleeping. No sleep, no memory formation, no learning. Not ideal for a student. And also, not getting enough sleep is going to affect everything that's important in terms of being a student the very next day. Let me read for you a quick little quote from Dr. John Medina's book, Brain Rules. The bottom line is that sleep loss means mind loss. Sleep loss cripples thinking in just about every way you can measure thinking. Sleep loss hurts attention, executive function, working memory, mood, quantitative skills, logical reasoning ability, and general math knowledge. So if you're a student, make sure you get adequate sleep. It's going to help you retain what you learn and help you the next day. Well, that's it. The top 10 rules of bad studying by Dr. Barbara Oakley. Stay tuned next month for a video blog, and check back every month for a new exciting blog dealing with accelerated learning techniques and valuable life skills. Until next month, I'm Joe McCullough. I'll see you later.